with the girls from Dead or Alive Beach Volleyball. I'm Jamie Atiko.
And I'm Darren Malcolm, and this is the show that all you gamers have been waiting for.
We are the CPR machine that kickstarts the heart of gaming. Clear?
Oh, thank you, Jay. And we've got some great games on the show today. But before that, Jay, I just want to congratulate you on your completion of Ghost Recon on Elite, sir.
Well, it was a multiplayer co-op mission, so I'd like to congratulate you too, sir.
And we've also got Ghost Recon and Raven Shield 6-3. In our Clash of the Titles.
Now, speaking of Elite, Dar, we've got some Elite games in Gamesville today, mate. I'm itching. I just can't wait to show the people.
Just go and scratch that itch, mate. Go and scratch that itch.
Cheers, Dar. Now, first of all, in the PC lounge, we have got Freedom Fighters. Now, this is a futuristic third-person adventure game. And I just can't wait. But I must say, this is a 16+. So, discretion is a must. Moving on to the console kitchen, we have got Alter Echo. Now this is a game where you can actually be three different characters. Sounds mad, right? Can't wait to take a closer look at that one later. And in the mobile pad today, we have got Summer Games 2004, and we've got Deep Snow, which is a snowboarding game on your latest mobile phones. Last but by no means least though, we have got these people. The G Team. Putting it simply, these are the tip of the iceberg when it comes to gaming. Now you want to comment about anything you've seen today, or you want to just send me and Daz a message, you know what to do. You email the boys at gamesville.tv.
That's the boys at gamesville.tv.
And like I said, you can message us. UK digital satellite viewers, pick up your remote control, press that red button. It will cost you 25p, but do get permission of the bill payer first.
Well, Jay, my thumbs are itching a bit, so you know what that means.
What's that, mate?
Let's get gaming. It's round one of our face-off, and today we are playing Street Fighter EX3 on the PS2. Now, there's been over 20 Street Fighter titles since 1987, but this one is the first to be done in 3D, and we've got two gamers here to settle their differences with a serious grudge. And Jay, I can't wait, mate.
Neither can I, mate, so let's meet our gamers. Kia.
I'm Kia.
How you doing, mate? Welcome to Gamesville.
I'm fine.
Now, what console do you have at home, or do you have a console?
Yeah, I've got GameCube and Game Boy Advance.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Okay, so this is obviously on the PS2.
Yeah.
Have you played the PS2 before?
Yeah, of course.
And how are you in Street Fighter games, mate?
I'm all right.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Now, you've had a few practice goes this morning, yeah?
Yeah.
So you're going to be ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. I'm
confident?
Confident.
Nice one. I'm back in Kia today.
All right, Raphael, welcome to Gamesville.
Hi. We have this grudge. I'm going to beat him, hopefully. Hopefully, I'm going to beat him. It's my home console, so... Yeah, I should beat him.
Do you know what? I didn't even ask you what the grudge was.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead. Tell him, man. Why are you here again? Just reiterate.
Yeah,
why are you here?
I'm just... We've been growing up as kids, and basically we've had a grudge, and we just want to settle our differences on this game.
Well, you seem ready, man.
Yeah, I do seem
so,
ready.
So you're familiar with the Street Fighter titles?
Yeah, I'm familiar with the Street Fighter titles.
Yeah.
I'm just not familiar with this game.
All right, well, this is the first 3D one, so it's slightly different.
Okay.
You know, if you're used to Tekken and stuff like that, then you'll be used to this.
Yeah.
Well, looking forward to it, man.
Me too. Well, gamers are ready, me and Daz are ready, audience is ready, but for everyone who needs a closer look at this game, you need to take a look at this.
Street Fighter X3 is the first Street Fighter game to hit the PS2. The X series started life as an arcade game, then moved on to the PS1. They were the first of the Street Fighter games to be 3D. X3 has added tag battle, more moves and more characters into the mix, and it plays at a blinding rate. And with the old Street Fighter games enjoying a mobile phone resurgence, we're sure to see a new game on the console soon.
Okay, so I think our gamers are ready. Now, just to remind you, these guys grew up together playing games. Never a good thing. So they've come on Gamesville here today to sort out their differences and decide who really is the best.
Well, I'm back in Kia, but first of all, before we get this one on, let me explain the rules. Face-offs are split into three rounds throughout the show. Each round is 2 minutes long. And basically, this one is a bit different. Well, we've seen it before, but I mean, it's different to the other Street Fighter.
This one's a tag battle, James.
Exactly. You've got two fighters to control. So you're not just one fighter, you've got two fighters. So get ready with your tags, guys. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Yeah, pick up your pants.
Are you guys ready?
You ready?
Yeah.
Oh, right. We're definitely ready, so I want to get it on, mate.
I'm amped, man.
3, 2, 1.
Let the games begin!
Okay, so we've got Raphael, who is playing as Chun Li.
We know that Chun Li's very fast with her legs, Jay. Very fast.
Very fast,
man.
Helicopter kick. And in comes Guile. With the spinning back kick.
Kia has just used a special tag move where you can get both of your players on the screen at once, Jay.
And it's very effective, dude.
Now,
very
effective, mate. Because this is a tag battle, Jay, this game is only being played for one round.
Right, you are, Daz. But it's a fast and furious round, I tell you. Come on, Kia. Kia's getting back into this first round. Raphael is looking pretty good, I have to say.
All right, so just to remind you guys, we've got Raphael playing as Jack and Chun Li. Jack is on the screen at the moment on the left-hand side.
And we've got Kia, who's playing as Guile and Vega. And Guile is on the right-hand side at the moment. It's pretty even, Steven.
It's pretty even at the moment. Some very basic moves being pulled, Jay. Very basic moves.
Guile's energy's looking very low at the moment. And in comes Vega.
Special tag move there. Like it.
Wicked stuff, mate.
And Chun Li and Jack are really suffering at the moment, it looks like.
Well, yeah, Chun Li, she's holding it up for her team.
Okay.
She's the only one in there.
So Raphael is playing as Chun Li and Jack. Oh, great spinning kick there.
Come on, Raphael. Raphael is playing with... Oh, and he's down.
One player gone, only Chun Li left.
Well, Vega's got to be the favourite against Chun Li. He's got a lot more energy. Come on, Raphael, you're nearly there, and the time has run out. The time has run out, but we have a winner. And his name is Kia. How you doing, mate?
I'm fine, man.
How'd that feel, man?
Really good, really
good. That was some serious, fast and furious gameplay.
Thank you very much, man.
I mean, I couldn't call it, to be honest, but you did really well. You did really well, mate. And same again for round 2?
Yep.
I mean, what kind of tactics were you using there? Was you, like, jumping more or...?
I was more of the defensive side, but...
Right.
I'm going to go for the offensive.
Good man. 1-0.
Well, how are you feeling?
I feel terrible. Right? He doesn't have a PS2. I don't believe I'm losing on my home console.
Well, don't worry about it. You've still got the second and third round to play for. It's not over yet. All right? So don't feel too bad, mate. Well, from our first victory to our first review. I'm here in the console kitchen with Simon, Darmesh and Jamie. And these guys are taking a look at a brand new adventure game on the PS2 called Alter Echo. Now, this game allows you to morph into 3 different characters. Sounds like fun, sounds a bit weird. Take a look at this.
Alter Echo is a new and very bizarre game. Underneath the vibrant colours and cartoony gameplay lies a third-person adventure with a very original twist. You take the role of Nevin. He's an expert shaper with the most valuable commodities in the galaxy, called Plast. Confused? Okay. Plast is powerful but hard to work with. It can be shaped into organic forms and can, of course, be used for good or evil. So guess what? Nevin, that's you, must make sure that the plast-ridden planet on which he lives doesn't get taken over by the evil shapers who want to rule the galaxy. The gameplay gives you the ability to transform yourself into 3 forms, and you can switch between them during battles. If the enemies get too much to handle, you can enter time dilation mode, which lets you freeze time. Then you can attack the enemies using a mini-game that plays a bit like Parappa the Rapper mixed with Snake. Alter Echo is out on PS2, Xbox and GameCube.
Well, it looks like a strange game with a very weird storyline. Is it as weird as you, Si?
Yeah, it is a bit weird. You get to play as 3 characters. Well, it's all one character, a guy called Nevin. He's a thing called a shaper.
A shaper?
A shaper.
That means he can do what?
He can, you know what, he can shape himself into lots of different
forms.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, cool.
He's got this thing called, he's a master of this thing called Plast.
Yeah.
Yeah, which means he can shape-shift himself into either a big gun form,
Who's
really hard but really slow,
right.
Or a stealth form who can sneak up on people but doesn't have much in the way of weapons, and the sword form, which is what the guys are playing right now. But what the great thing about the molding into 3 different players is you can start off in the stealth form, sneak up on someone, bash them a little bit, quickly turn into the gun form, fire at them, and then quickly turn into the sword form and take them out.
So there's a lot of tactics you can use to use your shapeshifting to an advantage,
it's
basically.
It's really, really original. Because, you know, it's difficult to reinvent the wheel, isn't it?
Absolutely.
It's a third-person adventure at the end of the day.
Yeah, and there's a lot of those about.
THQ have done a very good job of making this an extremely original-looking title.
Well, let me just find out what these gamers think. Now, I've got Jamie over here. Jamie, welcome to Gamesville. Well, now, you've been playing it. I mean, what's your verdict on this game?
I think it's a really good game. Like, it's got a lot of graphics. But I like the sword as well, because you can have lightning sword.
Yeah? Which is your favourite thing to morph into?
Probably the sword, because it's a lot quicker than the gun.
Yeah, a lot faster.
Yeah.
So you impressed with the graphics and the gameplay?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah? And Darmesh, welcome to Gamesville.
Thank you.
What about you? What do you reckon of the game?
I think it's pretty good. The graphics look good, but at the moment, I've only tried out the sword, so I don't know what the other ones are.
Now, you into third-person shooter games?
Yeah.
Is this the kind of game you think you recommend to your friends?
Yeah, I would.
Yeah? I mean, you're totally intrigued in it, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah? Spend loads of hours on it?
Definitely.
Well, these guys seem to think it's good. I think it looks absolutely brilliant. Simon, I mean, if you were going to give this a Gamesville rating out of 5 Gs, what would you give it, mate?
Well, I think it's very original. There's a nice little thing called time dilation. The graphics aren't to everyone's taste, but they're really nice. Mm. I'd like to give it a 4, but it's just not quite good enough, so it's got to be a 3G rating.
It's not up to Simon's standards.
Not quite. It's nearly there.
All right, what do you reckon, Jay?
Three characters all in one.
Yeah.
That sounds crazy.
It's not bad, is it?
Well, I tell you what, Dale, I mean, I could think of someone else who's three characters all rolled in one. I think you know who I'm talking about.
Not
this. It's time for us to see at Games Guru.
Boys, I am ready to share my wisdom. Who needs it?
Hi, Games Guru. Is there any way to stop me being overcome by the dark side in Star Wars and Clone Wars on the PS2?
The dark side is an awesome force, Sam. But fear not, for the Guru is on your side. I have a little secret I can share with you, my friend. Heed my words. Heed my words. Dark side. Dark side is the password you must enter. Dark side, uppercase, no space. To defeat the dark side, you must enter their name. How ironic, Sam.
Thank you, Guru. Never lets us down, does he, Daz?
Never.
And he'll never let you down. If you want to get in touch with him, send your emails to guru@gamesville.tv.
That's guru@gamesville.tv.
And don't forget, UK digital satellite viewers, if you've missed any hints, cheats or tips, pick up your remote control and get busy with the red button.
But still to come, guys, we've got two great games for your Java phones as we take a look at Summer Games 2004 and Deep Snow.
And we'll be firing up a new game in the PC Lounge. I'm talking about Freedom Fighters on the PC.
All that still to come right here on Gamesville.
Ewan McGregor and Charlie Borman ride rough from London to New York.
Have you got secure parking? Yes, just put them in the foyer.
Two men, four wheels and 20,000 miles.
Look at this place.
Brand new, The Long Way Round. Monday 9 o'clock, Sky One. Wednesday on Sky Travel.
Nivea Visage Age Reversal. With the power of pure vitamin C. Helps to smooth and firm your skin. Leaving it visibly rejuvenated. And leaving you with noticeably younger-looking skin. In fact, 69% of women asked agreed that Age Reversal outperformed their usual moisturizer. Positive proof from Age Reversal and Nivea Visage. Face care inspired by the way your skin works.
Morning. Now, it's never been so important that nippers eat proper grub. That's why I've rustled up my new kids' meals. They're nutritionally balanced, specially made for little ones. Let's give them the good stuff.
Find my kids' meals in the frozen ready meal aisle.
Life's full of choices. And like many women during the menopause, I take new Imea, which contains natural phytoestrogens.
Imea, for the time of your life.
You can't help being pleased when you stock up with any two of these packs of beer for only £20 at Asda.
It's faster if you file your tax return online.
Self-assessment online. Tax doesn't have to be taxing.
Van Nistelrooy. De Leon's made a good run forward. So too is Rooney. Now then, is this the moment? Oh, it is! Van Nistelrooy. De Leon's made a good run forward. So too is Rooney. Now then, is this the moment? Oh, it is!
Welcome back to Gamesville. Now, you don't see many third-person action games on the PC, right, Dee?
Absolutely, mate.
But we have got one today, mate, because we're looking at Freedom Fighters in the PC lounge.
And we've also got a great little game for your mobile phone. I'm talking about snowboarding as we take a look at Deep Snow. But first, it's round two of our face-off! Yay! And we are playing Street Fighter EX3 on the PS2. And we've got two gamers with a great grudge here today, Raphael and Kia. Now, Kia won the first round, and it's all to play for in the second round.
Yes! 3, 2, 1, let the games begin!
Okay, so we are playing Street Fighter EX3 on the PS2, and we've got Raphael, who's playing as Chun-Li and Jack on the right-hand side of the screen.
That's right, Dee, and I've got Raphael over... I've got Kia over here, even, and he's playing as Guile and Vega.
And we are playing for 2 minutes. One fight per round, Jay, because it is a tag battle.
Yes, no doubt. I was very surprised that the time actually ran out in the last round.
Yeah, no, we do like to see a knockout here at Gamesville.
Yeah, we don't like to see a points decision, do you?
Absolutely not, mate. I don't believe in points decisions.
Nah, mate. Right, come on, guys. 70 seconds left. I want to see a clear winner in this round. And I know it's going to be you, Kia, mate. Same again.
I mean, Jay, you do usually see Street Fighter in its 2D form, and this is the first 3D game. Do you think they've done it well?
Yeah, I love it, D. They've just brought it basically into modern times, do you know what I mean?
Absolutely, mate.
Come on, Raph.
Pretty good round. It's pretty even at the moment.
All right, so we've got Raphael, who is playing as Jack and Chun-Li.
Come on, Raph. Switch.
And Kia, who's playing as Guile and Vega.
And Vega, he is. And Guile was down. We just have Vega left. That's all we have left.
Okay, so Raphael coming a lot harder in this round.
Tell you what, Dar, it's a lot quicker than Tekken or Virtual Fighter, isn't it?
It is a lot quicker than Tekken. Tekken's a little bit more methodical. This is a bit more button bashy.
Yep. Well, both players have got one character left. It's Vega against Chun-Li.
Great special move there by Raphael.
Kia's looking good, but Chun-Li is hanging in there.
Yep, fastest legs in the West. Or the East,
for
Steven.
Sure. You're right, mate. I think Vega might have the longest, though. A lot of reach, this guy. We've got 10 seconds. Come on now. We've got 10 seconds. Can I get a winner in round two? Clear winner in round two. We want to knock out.
We want to knock out, guys. We want to knock out.
We
have a winner in round two, and his name is Raphael. Getting some love from the audience there.
Ooh.
Well, are you happy about that?
Yeah, I'm happy. I'm happy.
Very close battle. Again, no knockouts, really.
Yeah.
But, well, I mean, why do you think you guys aren't finishing each other off?
Because we're equal in the gaming world. You see, we've got our grudge, and like we've played all the games at the same time. So
your abilities are very equal.
Yeah, they're equal.
Well, you've got all to play for in the third round, and I'm afraid there's got to be a decider in that round. So the friendship's got to go out the window, I'm afraid.
Right, you are, Baz. Right.
Yeah.
That's right. It's all to play for in round three. Now, what different tactics you going to use? Because it was close. It was very close, wasn't it? But
I need to hit him more.
Yeah. Go for maybe some of them big power moves, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, we will be coming back for round three. I can't wait.
Jay, I'm pumped.
But right now, let's check in with everything that's good and great with those gaming gods, the G-Team.
Matt, how you doing, mate?
Fine, thanks. You?
Good. What's happening?
Good. Well, what is not happening? That's what I'd like to ask you.
What is not happening?
Well, this is not happening, I'm telling you. There's a new game coming out, which is very exciting, called Resident Evil Outbreak. Have you heard of it?
No.
Okay. Think of Resident Evil, scary single-player game.
Yep.
Think of it online.
What?
Exactly. Online play, You've got a group of people all together, well, not together at the beginning, all trying to find their way out of this survival horror nightmare surrounded by zombies. Sounds exciting, doesn't it?
It sounds absolutely amazing.
Exactly. The Japanese are finding it exciting. Yeah. The Americans are finding it exciting. It looks like we may not be able to play it online in Europe.
I'm quite a big fan of Resident Evil.
So
I played 1 and 2 and completed them both. And to have an... yeah, I do a bit of gaming in my spare time, okay. Matt. But to have it online, I think would just make the game absolutely amazing. I think it would make it so much better. Yeah. It's going to make it more exciting, right,
it's
Matt?
It's intriguing, so let's hope we can play it over here.
Well, Matt, thanks for that great news, my man. Simon, how you doing?
Very good, mate.
So what great news you got for me today?
Not so great, actually. You know Hideo Kojima?
Yeah, Metal Gear Solid?
Yeah, legendary creator of the Metal Gear Solid series. Well, Metal Gear Solid 3 is going to be the last game that he's going to design, apparently.
Really?
Well, the last Metal Gear Solid game, anyway.
Oh, right, okay, so what's he designing now, then?
Well, it hasn't been said exactly what he's going to be working on, but he's going to be going on to other projects at Konami, so we'll be seeing more games from him,
cool.
Not to worry.
All right, so what other news have you got for me?
Well, Sega.com, they've just announced here that the last of the Dreamcast online titles, they're going to be wound up, I'm afraid.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, Dreamcast, you could put it on the Antiques Roadshow now, couldn't you?
Well, it still holds its own against a lot of the consoles out there. Yeah. A lot of us here at Gamesville, we're big fans of the Dreamcast.
Yeah.
And it's going to be really sad to see the online games wrapping up.
Yeah.
So. But this winter 2003 is going to be the end. Jamie.
Right, people, I hope you've got your pens and papers ready because this is our freebie section. This is where we give you the best free downloadables from the World Wide Web. Well, Sarah does. Let's meet her. How are you doing, Sarah?
I'm very well, thank you.
You all right today?
Very well.
Right, now what have you got for me today?
I've got a couple of sporty freebies for you. This first one's set in the high-speed world of remote control racing cars.
Ooh.
And it's a game called Stunt GP. And it's just a demo of the full game, but it's a really good demo. It's totally free.
Mm-hmm.
Play it as many times as you like, and it's really, really...
It's brilliant.
I've just fallen off the track. But that's the good thing about this game, because if you fall off, your stunt goes wrong, you get put straight back onto the track and off you go again. You're actually racing against other players, and so you've really got to really concentrate.
Is it easy to control, or is it difficult?
Yeah, it's all the curses, and it is actually quite easy to control. I'm just not doing very well at the moment. But, I mean, when you get air, when you get extra points and things like that, you know, you've done your really good stunts.
Mm-hmm.
It's worth it.
This is really good, though, and this is just a free demo you can download and just get cracking straight away.
You can download a 15 megabyte playable demo of this, and it is really worth it, definitely.
I like this one. Yeah, I do like this a lot. What else you got for me, though, Sam?
This next one is a total freebie, Flash Arcade, and it's a game called River Kayak. And River Kayak is a game where you're racing down a river and trying to avoid all the rocks and the trees that are stuck in.
This is fast and furious,
it
Sarah.
It is very fast. You're going down rapids. It's actually a lot harder than it looks.
Sarah, once again, a massive thank you.
You're welcome.
For your help. And now we're going to move on to messages. So coming from freebies to messages, the first one is from James Budd from Swindon. And he wants to know, what are your favourite sports games? Well, James, to be honest, I love sports. I love all sports. I'd have to say my favourite type of sports game would have to be a footy game. But there's so many more sports games out there, like Tony Hawk, skating, you've got Matt Hoffman, BMX, you've got Wakeboarding Unleashed. So, I mean, I love sports, but my favourite would have to be footy. And the second is from Stephen House in Reading, and Ashish Sood as well. And they both want to know, which one of you is the better gamer? Well, I'm tempted to just stand here and go, me. But I think, Daz, what do you reckon? I mean...
Well, I'm better at driving games.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. Daz is definitely the driving guy. But when it comes to beat-em-ups, and when it comes to first-person shooters, both of us, we usually play as a team. So if there's anyone out there that thinks they can take us on with a first-person shooter game, you know what to do. It's the boys at Gamesville.tv.
That's the boys at Gamesville.tv.
And UK digital satellite viewers, do not forget, you can also message us very, very easily. Pick up your remote control and get busy with that red button. It will cost you 25p, but do get permission from the bill payer first.
Well, now it's time to go over to Lucy, who's got a first glance look for us.
This is ECTS, Europe's largest and noisiest computer games exhibition. It's got all the latest computer games months before they've hit the shops, but it's an industry-only event. What does that mean? Well, I'm afraid if you don't have one of these exclusive passes, you're just not coming in. But don't worry, because Gamesville don't want you to miss a single thing, so just sit back, relax, and check out my whistle-stop tour.
My first stop is Atari and Kaya Dark Lineage. It's basically an action-adventure romp through a fantastical, mystical land. You follow the heroine as she tries to battle against all kind of dangers in an attempt to rescue her brother who's been lost. And then she's got to find her way back home. There's a lot of twists and turns in the gameplay to keep you occupied for hours. And that brings me on to my next game, Beyond Good and Evil, which puts you in the shoes of an investigative reporter on a mission to try and uncover a secret government conspiracy. It looks great and plays like a dream. That coupled with stunning environments and a great storyline makes this game a possible game of the year. Another contender could be F-Zero GX. The sheer speed and awesome graphics of this game will leave you quite literally breathless. And while you're waiting, let me tell you about Medal of Honor Rising Sun. Oh yes, this fantastic first-person shooter is making its way back to your console. They haven't changed much since the last time round, which I personally think is a really good thing. However, they've taken on board some of the criticisms from the last game and drastically improved the level design and environmental detail. Next! Mario Kart Double Dash has to be one of the most anticipated GameCube titles ever. Mario Kart is a classic series, and this latest one gives you two characters in your kart and loads of crazy new weapons. You can also play up to 8 players if you link up your consoles. Well, there you have it. That was ECTS 2003. We will, of course, be bringing you more info on all the top titles, so make sure you stay tuned to Gamesville. It's been an amazing day, but I'm absolutely exhausted, and it's just about all I can handle for now.
Right, I'm in the PC lounge where we are looking at a brand new game. It's called Freedom Fighters, and I'm with Simon and David. But basically, this game totally rewrites history. The Soviet Union didn't collapse. They were the first people to make and drop an atomic bomb. And get this, they are the world's superpower. Now, the only country they haven't taken over is, wait for it, guess? You're right, the US. But hey, the Soviets are just about to attack. Take a closer look.
That's right, Jamie. Freedom Fighters is a brand new third-person offering for the PC. You play as a New York plumber called Christopher Stone. The game sees you fight to rescue your brother and overthrow the Soviet enemies. This game has been developed with certain elements that set it apart from the average third-person shooter. For example, the battlefield grows as you play, with New York City gradually becoming more and more degraded. Your character changes too, from a regular Joe to a grizzled freedom fighter throughout the course of the game. This sure seems to be a breath of fresh air that has the potential to rejuvenate the first and third person shooter genre. Whether it does or not, we'll have to wait and see.
Right, we've had a brief description of what's the game about, but let's have a look in more detail. Si, how you doing, mate?
Very good, mate.
I was going to say welcome to Gamesville, but you're a resident, eh?
Yeah, always here, mate. Never leave.
Now, what is so special about this game, Si?
Well, what's so special about it? It's a beautiful game, first off, yeah? I think it looks great. Secondly, the whole history part of it, it's really nice. It really sucks you in. There's a great movie at the beginning. It really gives you some depth to the game. I mean, there's some really nice features in the game. For example, when you're playing the game, there's like you've got this charisma bar, which is just below your health bar.
Okay.
And you build it up. As you help people through the game, you get more charisma. And it allows you basically to recruit people to help you in your fight. And then you've got this really, really easy controls. You just press like 1, 2, or 3 to either get them to follow you, get them to attack, or get them to defend. So that really adds another dimension to what is basically a third-person shooter. It starts to become a little bit more strategic.
Let's move on to graphics.
Well, frankly, I think the graphics are beautiful. I think it's really nice, really detailed. It's a massive game. There's some huge levels. It's really free-roaming. I mean, just take a look at the light shining through the window there.
Yeah. I mean, I have to be honest with you, Si. When I looked at it, we're going to have a difference of opinion here, but I mean, the light looks, it's a nice touch, but I wasn't overly impressed. I think the walls and the actual character, it could be
Jay,
a bit more.
I don't think you're giving it a chance, mate. You need to play it for a longer period of time, and then you really start to get a feel for the graphics of this game. I mean, it is available on all platforms, including PlayStation, Xbox, and GameCube, but the PC version's by far the most powerful version, and it's got the most detail in it.
Right. Now, Dave. Welcome to Gamesville, mate.
Right.
Sitting there all quiet, getting on with your gameplay.
Yeah.
What do you think of it? How'd you find it?
It's a good game. It's easy to get used to the controls, so it's a good game.
Lots of action?
Yeah, plenty of action.
Right, now Si, my man.
Yeah.
Big question, mate. I need a G rating out of 5 Gs for this game.
Well, it's a very, very good game. And I'd like to give it a 5, but you've got to be exceptional in Gainesville to get a 5. So I'm going to give this game 4 Gs.
Right. You heard it from our expert, Freedom Fighters on the PC. It's 4 Gs. Cheers, Simon, mate.
No problem.
Thank you, David.
Thanks. Well, Jay, looks quite a decent game, huh? Third-person shooter?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Set in the future. Good storyline.
Not bad. Well, Jay?
Yeah, mate?
Enough of this, mate, because now we're going to find out who's button-bashing their way to victory in our street fighting finale.
It's round 3 of our face-off, and this one is the big one. This is the decider. We've got our two gamers locked head-to-head. It's one round each, and this is the third and final.
Who do you think is going to win this round?
Oh, definitely. Yeah?
No. What about you?
Yeah, I think he will.
Well, these guys think it's
back
Raphael.
In Raphael.
They're backing Raphael, but there's only one way to find out, Jay.
Don't know about backing Raphael.
Please do the honours, mate.
Right, pick up your pads, guys. Ready? 3, 2, 1,
let the games begin!
All right, so this is our third and final round of Street Fighter EX3 on the PS2. Now I've got Kia, who is playing with Guile and Vega, and he's on the left-hand side of your screen at the moment. And we've got Raphael, who's playing as Chun-Li and Jack.
Come on, Raph, don't have to.
Now, this is seriously fast and furious dance.
Absolutely, Jay. And if you've never heard of Street Fighter, then you just haven't lived, have you?
Yeah, I don't know what planet you're
on. I don't know, Google.
I don't know if you know this, mate, but you can actually be a 4-player on this.
Oh, Jay, I'd love to play a 4-player on this. It would be absolutely fantastic.
Pretty intense, right?
All right, so it's pretty equal at the moment. It's both of them just trading blows.
Yep, 50-50.
Yeah, so we've got Raphael playing as Jack and Chun-Li. At the moment, Gil has a slight advantage.
Yeah. Kia playing as Guile here. He's coming in with the sweeps.
He is coming in with the sweeps.
He's looking good, actually. Taking Jack out, and he's got one more character, just Chun-Li.
Oh, Chun-Li's just coming with some very fast legs there.
Would not like to get on the wrong side of Chun-Li.
No, mate. She looks sweet and innocent, Jay, but I bet she's absolutely brutal.
Yep, I think you're right, Dad. I'll tell you what, these are the... Oh, and Guile's in the ring now.
Ooh.
Well, good tagging from Kia.
Oh, great special move there.
Took a few to the chin there.
Yep. Combos are very important in this game. Very, very important.
Now, you really have to... Guys, this is all about timing. But, I mean, a good button basher now. I mean, you can never knock them on Street Fighter.
No, I mean, yes and no, Jay.
Oh, we have a result! We do have a result! And we do have a champion! I'm losing my feet. I'm falling all over the place here. It's crazy in the face-off zone. But I just got to shake your hand.
Thank you very much,
well
man.
Done. It's all How'd good. You do it, mate?
I'm just a champion.
You are a champion. You are a champion. I mean, what tactics? Because, I mean, it was one each. It was tense. It was close all the way. So, I mean, how did you pull it out of the bag?
I just done more offense, and then he's gone, innit?
You just did brilliant gaming.
Thank you very much.
Well done, mate.
Raphael, you lost that round.
Yeah, I did.
What do you think went wrong?
I don't know exactly. I think he got more hits in and made him win.
Yeah, I think he did get more hits in.
Yeah, he did.
That's probably why you lost.
Yeah.
Dad, leave him alone, mate. You're terrible.
All right.
Now, Kia, you are today's face-off champion.
Of course.
Right? And I mean, as we speak, there are people writing up your certificate now.
Yeah.
But we don't want to give it to you as it is. We want to put an elite stamp on there. But you have to earn that, my friend.
Cool.
You have to play either me or Daz in a face-off.
Yeah.
And who do you want?
And you get to choose.
Daz.
You want Daz?
Going
down. Right, now that is coming up. That is coming up soon. We'll see if Kia can get his elite stamp. But right now, it's time to get some wisdom. So you know who we need to see? It's the Games Guru.
I am here, boys. I am here, for I am knowledgeable, and you are not. Who seeks my guidance?
Game Guru, I love using the lightsaber from Jedi Archives, the one team since the beginning. Can I get one early in the game?
Greed, Laura. Greed is what I sense from you. You love the lightsaber, but you want it immediately. I can help you, my friend, but you must heed my words and not turn too greedy. At the cheat menu, type in the word fudge. That's it, Laura. That one simple word will grant your wishes. The lightsaber is at your disposal. Next. Dan wants to know how to stop Drek on the last level of Ratchet and Clank. He just can't do it. You just can't do it, Dan. You just can't do it. The Guru has no time for slackers, my friend. I must help you before it is too late. Listen to my wisdom. Make sure you have the Devastator, loads of ammo, and the PDA equipped. Jump over his shockwaves and avoid his missiles, Dan. Keep firing at him with the Devastator, and eventually you will defeat him. That simple, my friend. Be a slacker no more.
Guru, your knowledge never ceases to amaze me. And if you want the knowledge, contact guru at gamesville.tv. That's guru at gamesville.tv. And UK digital satellite viewers, do the right thing and pick up the remote and press that little red button if you've missed any hints, cheats or tips. Right, still to come on the show, we have got two Tom Clancy titles going head to head in our Clash of the Titles. And we take it back to 1985 as we take a retro look at Ghosts and Goblins. So don't go anywhere because it's all coming up right here on Gamesville.
I understand, but I don't think you understand how critical the situation is out there. People are gonna start dying.
Always better when the oppressed don't fight back, isn't it?
Battlestar Galactica, Monday at 8, exclusive to Sky One.
Sainsbury's reckon they're serious about making the Taste of Difference range even better. Okay. So serious they've employed John Wood, a Michelin-starred chef.
Is it just regular stuff in posh packaging?
Absolutely not. Take this cheddar, made from a 50-year-old traditional family recipe.
Mm.
To me, Taste of Difference means the best of what we sell.
But you're going
to
say that, aren't you?
Not just me. We've blind tested all of our new products. If they don't come up to scratch, we don't sell them. It's about making everyday food taste great.
For a rich, replenishing moisturiser that melts into your skin, take Vaseline Intensive Care of yourself.
Widen up your overcoat when the wind is free. Take good care of yourself, you belong to me. Oh, eat an apple every day, get to bed by three. Take good care of yourself, you belong to me.
Get your free Cinema Paradiso DVD this Saturday in the Guardian.
Well, what do you mean?
Film on Sky Box Office is as easy as shooting fish in a barrel. Merely press the button to choose the film. There's no need to leave the sofa, there's nothing to return, there's no fine for lateness. Sky Box Office, where movies come first.
Welcome back to Gamesville. Still to come, it's going to be like track and field on your mobile phone. We're looking at Summer Games 2004, but is it any good?
We'll find out, Jay. And we're going to be getting on the Guru's nerves and we're asking more of your gaming questions.
But right now, it's time for today's Clash of the Titles. I'm playing Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Island Thunder.
And I'm playing Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six 3 Raven Shield. Now, Jay, I've got to start by saying, this is the latest in Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six series, and you get a chance to lead an elite force of a hostage rescue team through a series of very high-risk missions. This game is absolutely brilliant. I've got to say, Jay, buzzword,
of the day is realism. One shot and you're dead. It's over. Your fun is finished. Put down your pad, forget about it. This game is not for everyone. If you like first-person shooter games arcadey, leave this title on the shelf, my friend, because the tension alone will have your heart skipping a beat.
Well, Ghost Recon has basically taken the model of Rainbow and placed it in a Special Forces military-style game. By the way, Ghost Recon is also available on the Xbox, PS2 and GameCube. Also, Daz, you can't save in between missions. Are you crazy, mate? No frustrating restarts for me, mate. Just go, go, go.
CJ, buzzword of the day, realism. If you were in a real world, you wouldn't get a chance to save, Jamie. That's why this game does what Ghost Recon does, but only better and with more detail. This is the game that epitomizes Tom Clancy's novels of war and espionage. A game that forces you to use your head, not just your trigger finger.
Well, I love the variations in this game. Some missions you sneak around and others you go through just guns blazing. Don't get me wrong, Daz, I do like Raven Shield, unlike you. But Ghost Recon has better atmospheres and is more easily playable. The Island Thunder expansion pack that I'm playing is the icing on the cake for Ghost Recon games as far as I'm concerned. I'm talking 8 new single player missions, I'm talking 12 new weapons, and I'm talking about 5 new multiplayer spaces. Beat that, my friend.
Well, Jay, the Ghost wouldn't stand a chance against the Rainbow Six squad. So Jamie, lay down your weapons, because it's over.
Over.
Now, G-Team, please, put us out of our misery. Give us your verdict.
Well, because it's a little bit more varied and it's on the consoles, sorry, Daz, the winner is Ghost Recon.
Well, you heard it. Did you hear it, or do you need to hear from the G-Team again? No, you got it first time, right? Today, I win Clash of the Titles. Enough of this clashing stuff now, though. Let's go over to the mobile pad.
Okay, we're here in the mobile pad taking life a little bit easier because we're here with Lucy, our G-Team member, and she's got some great games for some mobile gaming on the move. I'm talking about 2 great games for your Java phones. Summer Games 2004 and Deep Snow, is it, Luce?
It is indeed.
Now, what can you tell us about these games?
Well, they're both obviously really sporty. One you play in the summer, one you play in the winter.
Yeah.
I've enjoyed playing both of them. I prefer the Deep Snow because I love skiing and boarding. This game is brilliant because you do feel like, well, you follow this guy and he's snowboarding down the mountain. You've got to get down to the bottom
right.
in a certain amount of time, avoiding all the obstacles. You can't do any crazy tricks, but it's a mobile phone game,
yeah.
so what do
no,
you expect?
Of course.
Do you know what
yeah.
I mean? The only thing is, I mean, I've done about 6 different levels. And after the second level, once you've mastered the second level, it gets a bit easy and then there's nothing much else there for you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay. Now this one is
Summer Games 2004. Yeah.
It's been likened to track and field. Now I really, really liked track and field in the arcade.
Brilliant game. Used to hurt the thumbs, but still loved it.
Exactly. It might look a bit like it, and the game is slightly similar in that it's track and field type games.
Right. Yeah.
But what you're doing is it's not a button basher. What you're doing is you've got to follow the arrows. Now to me it reminds me a little bit of whether or not you can actually what is it? Pat your head and rub your stomach at the same time. It's that kind of coordination. And you don't actually
look at him.
Well done.
You can do it. What's that? Come on, you do it.
I can't do it.
Exactly.
You're not gonna like this game. Basically you've got to follow the arrows and it doesn't really matter what images are there because you don't even need to look at them. You've just got to basically press the buttons and follow the arrows. So the gameplay isn't terribly exciting.
I mean, are these games are just gonna be like, you know, 5 minutes at a bus stop, or do you think you can take a lot of time and get really into them, or is it more like a...
The one that you'd play the most is Summer Games 2004, just because it's quite compelling and frustrating. It would keep you going for ages and ages.
Mm-hmm.
But fun-wise, I reckon Deep Snow. So, guys, you're going to ask me for a G rating?
No, if we have to, Luce, if we have to.
Come on, Luce, give it to us.
Okay, well, because I really, really like snowboarding and skiing, Deep Snow gets top rating from me, which is 4 out of 5. And I just wasn't too keen on Summer 2004, so that only gets 3.
Only 3 for Summer 2004?
Only 3,
yeah. Scores, though.
But, you know, it's my opinion, so...
Yeah, no, cool. Well,
4 and 3, fair
we
play.
We do value your opinion here at Games With All This.
Thank you.
Well, from mobile gaming to retro gaming, because we've got a classic for you, it's Ghosts and Goblins.
Right, so here we are at the retro table, and my earliest memories of Ghosts and Goblins have got to be Mega Drive, at home, with my brothers. I mean, I'm talking hours of gameplay on this one. This really was a good game.
I totally understand where you're coming from, Jay. I had it on the Commodore 64,
and I'd never seen a game with so much colour. I thought it was great. And it had quite a lot of spooky little atmosphere to it, didn't it?
Yeah, it was quite spooky.
Yeah, even though it was just a side-scrolling shoot-em-up or beat-em-up, it was absolutely brilliant. I loved it.
Now, Daz, let me take you back to 1985,
please,
my friend.
Please do.
Fingerless gloves were in vogue, and those robots in disguise, yes, the Transformers, were taking the nation by storm.
Oh, I love the Transformers. That's right, Jay. 85 was also the year that saw the Brat Pack wow the world with their rendition of Teen Angst in The Breakfast Club. But most importantly, the arcades were introduced to that plucky little knight, Sir Arthur, in Ghosts and Goblins.
Right, you are, Daz. Running, jumping, and shooting were the order of the day in this side and vertical scrolling shooter. You could choose from a variety of weapons, including a lance, dagger, and firebrand.
In this game, you got the chance to take on zombies and demons on the way to rescuing your princess. You had to battle through 6 levels, bro, on your way to rescuing your missus. Watch out for the gravestones, though, because if you shot one 15 times, a demon would appear and turn you into a frog.
Well, this was medieval action at its best, and one of my 1985 classics.
Well, Jay, now it's time to go over to someone else who could probably turn us into frogs. You know who that is, don't you?
Oh, do I?
Yeah, time to ask the guru.
Ask the guru. Boys, I am here. Who wishes to ask the guru? Samuel Fisher wants to know, why does everyone love Metal Gear Solid? He thinks it's rubbish. Samuel Fisher, eh? I sense you are a fan of the Splinter Cell. Metal Gear Solid is indeed a great game, but it has been criticized, my friend, for its long cutscenes and confusing story. But why be so picky, Samuel? They are indeed both good games. Play both. The guru does. Next. David Hughes writes, Guru, you look like a cross between George Clooney's mad half-brother and Robbie Williams. David, do not insult the guru by comparing me to such inferior mortals. George Clooney and Robbie Williams have nothing on the guru. They do not possess the wisdom. Be gone with your insolence.
Right, we're back in the face-off zone for our champion of champions finale. What am I talking about? This man here. His name's Kia and he's today's face-off champion. He beat his mate Raphael over there on Street Fighter EX3, 2-1, and it was fast and it was furious. But right now, he is just about to play Daz for an elite stamp on his certificate. Let's go over and meet our gamers. Kia, how you feeling, mate?
Fine. Confident.
Now, are you confident against Daz?
I don't know.
You don't know, do you? You haven't seen him play yet?
Nope.
So how do you think it's going to go?
It should go well.
Yeah? And Daz, you know you can't let the side down.
Do my talking on the consoles, man.
He does his talking on the consoles, so there's only one thing left to do. Guys, are we ready?
Yeah! Yeah!
All right, well, let's get this on. Right, pick up your pads, gentlemen. 3, 2, 1, let the games begin! Now we have got Daz, who's playing as Ryu at the moment, and we've got Kia on the left, who's playing as Vega and Guile. Daz is actually Ryu and Ken. This is a 2-minute round, and there can only be one winner. Who are you backing, guys? Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Daz, you can't let this side down, mate.
Come on, Daz.
It's quite even at the moment.
Come on, Kia.
Remember your blocks now.
Come on, Daz.
Kia's doing well at the moment. We've got 57 seconds left. Well done, Daz. Good fireball.
Come on, Daz.
Sweeps. Oh, Kenny's down. Kia's got one more character to go through, and he will earn his stamp. But it's not over yet. We've still got 42 seconds. Now, just to remind you, Daz is Ryu and Ken. So Daz is playing the guy in the white suit. Kia's the guy in the green trousers, Vega. Come on, Daz. You can do it, mate.
Come on, Kia.
You can do it. Tiny kicks.
Whoa, time is running out. We've got 22 seconds. Come on, guys, let me hear you. Let me hear you. Oh, we do have a winner, and we do have an elite gamer in the studio today. His name is Kia. How does it feel, mate?
Too good. Too good.
Kia, it gives me serious honor to award you today with your Face Off Champion Elite Certificate! Yay! Can we have a few words from today's champion?
Well, you just got to get better, innit?
Daz, that brings me on to you. What happened?
Do you know what, Jay? I'm terrible at Street Fighter. He picked the right guy for this one, I'll tell you that, mate.
Yeah, I think he did, actually.
What can I say?
I think he did. I think he might have seen me on the console earlier. A little bit. Right, you think that you can do better? You do. Email theboys@gamesville.tv.
That's theboys@gamesville.tv.
Also, for UK digital satellite viewers, you can pick up your remote control, press the red button and send us a message. It's very, very easy. It will cost you 25p, but do get permission from the bill payer first.
Now, guys, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for today.
Yeah. Oh, what? Already?
I know, Jay. Oh, I hate it. I hate this time of the show. But join us again for some serious Gamesville action! Yeah!
Just when you think you've seen it all...
Donkey basketball!
The Simpsons, as you've never seen them before.
Crack!
The only place to see brand new episodes of The Simpsons, 6:30 every Sunday.
Woo-hoo!
Sky One, the home of brand new Simpsons.
On Max Magic.
You're in the Costa del Sol with Ted.
I trust Joe completely and I'm not in the least bit scared of what might happen.
There's a fortune in transport.
Look, I see your card.
No!
Yeah!
Where?
There!
I got shot!
Oh my god.
We don't actually make the animals, like, when they don't come in like this, I'll show you what I mean. We make them to order, for example, get rid of that, we might need that. If we write like mouse, for example. Can you draw a mouse on there? Are you good at drawing? Can you draw? Draw me a little, I'll write mouse and then you draw a mouse. There you are. You draw me a mouse on there. I'll show you how it works. Because we don't have the animals in stock, like, they don't come in as animals, per se. We bring them in. That's it. Little mouse on there. That's not bad. Eyes, ears. That's lovely. That's great. And a little tail, leg. That's a mouse, isn't it? That's a lovely mouse. So
looks like
that.
Looks
like a dog. I like that. What we've got to do is we just got to put that in there. So this is how we make them to order. We don't know if you've ever... Just apply a bit of heat and you should be all right with it. Yeah, I like that. Just apply a bit of heat.
Oh my god. That
way. Yeah. That's how we make them in here. Yeah. Do you sketch quite a lot?
No, not at all.
That's good. And maybe a few whiskers, because he needs some whiskers. Has it got a name? Nick. All right, Nick the Mouse, all right. Nick the Mouse, all right.
Can we have a tail on him? A body and a tail on him, my dear? Because, I mean, you can't just have a mouse with a head, can you? I mean, the poor chap wouldn't live very long, would he?
All right, this is... There you go. Jerry the Mouse. Whoa. Saves a fortune in transport. Oh, there you go, make him up to order.
Oh, my God.
There you are.
Does she get to keep it now?
Well, she really made it. She made it.
No,
there you are.
No, that's
yours.
No.
There you are.
No, that's all right.
Nick the Mouse. Hello, Nick. All right. I must say, he'd come out just like your drawing.
Therapy, methinks, will help to recharge the batteries of all the busy shoppers here at Sunny Blue Water.
They'll never be the same again.
I'm Maximilian, and you are
Holly.
Amy. Amy.
Jack.
Jack, good to meet you. Have you ever seen one of these before?
Yeah.
You have. It's a magnetic board, and it's got magnetic letters on it. It's like when you're about 5 years old, and you're first learning how to read, and you're first learning how to write. There are lots of things that we do for the first time in life, like, for example, tying our shoelaces, or, for example, cleaning our teeth or driving a car. There are all sorts of things like that. Of course, then there's our first ever kiss. I remember my first ever kiss very vividly, actually. It wasn't particularly enjoyable, and I can remember her name. Now, Holly, if you can remember your first ever kiss, who it was and where it was, I want you to put your hand on your heart and keep it there. Splendid. Now, here's the interesting bit, because in a moment I'm going to ask you to spell his name out by blowing kisses at every letter on this board to spell his name. Okay, just the first name, not the second name, just the first name. Now, let's have a practice at blowing kisses. With your other hand, Holly, can you put those down for a moment for me?
Yeah.
Keep your hand on your heart. Keep your hand on your heart, that's good. With your other hand, Holly, I want you to just blow an air kiss at the D. Marvellous. A little bit more. Give us a little bit more, Holly. That's marvellous. Okay, now. Splendid, that's it. Just a little, you know, like a bit more in the blowing. Now, Holly, I'm going to turn away, and I want you to begin to blow in all innocence. Blow all the letters here that pertain to that chap's name. Have you done it?
Yeah.
Good. Can I turn back round? Let's see which of these letters are blushing. Now. Yeah. Oh, hang on. There you are. He's blushing. And that one's blushing. And, oh, that one's blushing. I think that's it. Now, Holly, I think I've got it, but I can give you much more information than this, Holly, with your help. I want you to give me your hand, and I want you to hold it nice and tightly like this, in the fingers. Because, you see, if you hold my hand, I can try and gauge your age at the time. I can't promise, but I'll try. I think... Yes, that's it. You weren't too young. You were about 14 or 15 at the time. Is that about right? About 14, 15? No? Look at me just for a moment. Okay. No. Younger.
Simon Cowell's new band, Il Divo, will be singing a song or two, plus there's a chat with David Dickinson. That's all on the Paul O'Grady Show, coming up at 3:25 this morning. First on ITV1, the latest computer and video games in Cybernet.
Hello, I'm Randy Fuller, in for Steve Truitt, and you're watching Cybernet. Stand by for the legendary X-Men, a golfing champion, a brutal battle, and a super samurai. It's ahead of the pack. It's Cybernet. We welcome you to the show and to the Xavier Institute for Higher Learning, better known as headquarters for the uncanny X-Men. These marvelous mutants are training for a dangerous new mission on the GameCube, Xbox, and PlayStation 2. So let's find out if these legends can pass the test. While previous X-Men appearances have been in mostly routine fighting games, Legends takes our heroes in a completely new direction. Here the gang is unleashed in a non-stop action RPG reminiscent of Baldur's Gate, Dark Alliance. In all, there are 15 superheroes on the roster, including Beast, Iceman, and Wolverine. Together, they'll fight an endless onslaught of henchmen, as well as supervillains like Mystique and the humongous Blob.
You X-Men are such tiny, frail things.
The X-Men's goal is to rescue a new mutant named Magma from the clutches of Magneto and the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants. At the outset, you'll have only Wolverine to control. He's the best at what he does, though, so don't worry if you're outnumbered. Soon after, you'll take command of four characters and complete various objectives like disabling generators and smashing tanks.
X-Men, I can show you some help.
This game superbly showcases the powers of these extraordinary heroes. Sure, they can all punch and kick, but it's their unique mutant abilities that really shine. Storm shoots lightning bolts, Jean Grey throws bodies with her telekinesis, and Cyclops fires off optic blasts. And if you need to build an ice bridge or put out a fire, just call on Iceman.
Let's see what you got.
Like other RPGs, as you progress, characters gain experience and improve fighting skills. You can also buy special items by selling the gold coins you collect. And if the bad guys are still too tough, you can always polish your fighting skills in the danger room. Legends is a very linear game, and the AI is occasionally problematic, but overall it's hugely enjoyable with effective controls and a cool story. Ultra-destructive environments, great graphics, and loads of challenges all combine to make this a legendary X-Men adventure. Enough said.
Oh, yeah. I'm back.
As an intergalactic warrior, your battles against the Empire shouldn't have to be limited to a few select planets. So grab a pen and jot down this cheat for Star Wars Battlefront on the Xbox. Go to the historical campaign mode and select the era you want to play. Then enter X, Y, X, and Y. Now you're free to roam the galaxy because we've just unlocked all the planets that this title has to offer. So keep your blaster charged and your lightsaber close, and may the Force be with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 1999 and 2000 PGA champion, Tiger Woods.
This golfing legend might be in a professional slump, but perhaps that's because his attention has been diverted to his virtual golf game. Let's find out if Tiger Woods still has the right stuff in PGA Tour 2005 for the PC and all consoles. So pick up the ticket, let's see your seatbelt fastened,
trunk rattling like you on the back seat. Handle the pressure there to sink that first.
This new edition is stuffed with terrific additions and upgrades. There's one in particular, though, that Tiger is especially excited about.
We got some new features in there with Legends of the Game.
I think it was pretty incredible to have the likes of Arnold Palmer and Jack Nicklaus, Ben Hogan, Gary Player, Sammy Ballesteros. Those are legends of the game, and to be able to have our past meet our present. I'm sure these guys never played games at all back in their day because it wasn't around. I don't think they play games now, but it's pretty exciting to have the likes of them join the 21st century.
To create an ultra-realistic swing simulation, Tiger was more than happy to strap on all the necessary motion capture sensors.
He helps us with the aspects of the game that are true to golf, and he also gives us a lot of input on how we build around the game of golf to make it a game fun for everyone.
Golf is a game of hand-eye coordination, and as Tiger demonstrates here, that's probably his greatest strength. Take a deep breath and exhale.
Girlfriend, boyfriend, boys. One of our new features this year is called Tiger Proofing. And Tiger Proofing is really a response that we've given to our customers who have told us that as the game progresses, the courses really kind of stay the same. So what we've done is we've implemented something that really happens in real life, where when major tournaments come to famous golf courses, the superintendents of those courses actually modify the characteristics of them to make them more difficult.
Earning legend coins will unlock as many as 20 different variables which can be used to alter courses that you've already mastered. Another improvement is the updated Game Face feature. This option now gives players greater depth and flexibility so they can create an exact facsimile of themselves, complete with scars, laugh lines, and freckles. Or if you want to go in the opposite extreme and design bizarre-looking characters, there's no limit to how odd you can make your golfing. The actual gameplay mechanics remain unchanged from last year, yet everything now seems much more forgiving. Several new real-life courses have been added, although sadly, many of the courses from the last version have been dropped. Modest graphical improvements are also noticeable in both the players' faces and on the fairways. Tiger Woods may no longer be ranked number one, but his PGA Tour 2005 is still the world's best golf simulation.
It's in the game. How'd I do that?
The sequel to the popular role-playing game Shadow Hearts is here. So gather your adventure gear because you're about to lead a new group of characters into battle in Covenant for the PlayStation 2. This fantasy begins 6 months after the events of the original. It's now the beginning of World War I, and Yuri returns to Europe where he meets Corinne, a German officer. Together, they embark on a quest to battle endless creatures in hopes of defeating the evil Rasputin and his plans of world domination. The combat here is turn-based, but unlike most games in this genre, you won't just choose an action and watch. Instead, your selections are more interactive thanks to the Judgment Ring. This clock-like indicator has a quick-moving hand that sweeps across different colored options. The objective is to stop the needle in the hit zone to unleash a devastating blow. Each character is endowed with their own magical abilities. Initially, they're weak, so to survive the boss encounters, you must build up your special skills. To do this, you have to collect specific items for that particular character. Unfortunately, this requires a lot of backtracking through previously cleared areas, which can be a bit maddening. The lush graphics are on par with Final Fantasy XI, but even though the production values complement the storyline, Shadow Hearts Covenant doesn't add anything new to the genre. This may disappoint RPG fans who will probably gravitate toward higher concept and open-ended games such as the superior Fable. Okay, it's time for CyberNet's Top 10 Xbox Game Chart. At number 10, whether it's bugs or brutes, Ryu Hayabusa of Ninja Gaiden knows all about sword slashing. We think our rent should be severely reduced after surviving the nightmare of Silent Hill 4, The Room, at 9. At number 8, the world of underground racing is taking off as we light up the night with Street Racing Syndicate. Football season is in full swing, so we're not surprised that ESPN NFL 2K5 has scored in the 7th position. At 6, some people like to race while others like to crash, but if you have a penchant for both, check out Burnout 3 Takedown. With another strong offering this year, Madden NFL 2005 continues to rule the gridiron at number 5. At 4, Marvel's mutant heroes are joining together to fight the forces of evil in X-Men Legends. Get ready to sink some difficult putts with Tiger Woods in PGA Tour 2005, hitting the links in the 3rd spot. At number 2, choose the path of good or evil as you battle through a world of magic and mystery in Fable. But taking the top spot, it's Star Wars Battlefront jumping into hyperspace as our Xbox number 1. We all like to collect things, but this little prince is out of control. He's having a ball gathering anything he can get his sticky little hands on in Catamaran.